Dr. Mark Gurney, CEO of Tetra Therapeutics, discusses how one of the earliest clues to the biology of Fragile X led to the most successful Fragile X clinical trial to date. FRAXA and Tetra began working together after a key FRAXA-funded study caught the attention of Dr. Gurney. Through the FRAXA Drug Validation Initiative, Dr. Patricia Cobram was able to conduct preclinical validation experiments with Tetra's lead compound in record time, paving the way for clinical trials.
So one of the early biochemical, one of the initial biochemical changes that was reported in patients with Fragile X was a change in cyclic AMP, a decrease in cyclic AMP. And cyclic AMP is an important signaling molecule in pathways for neuroplasticity that allow neurons to make connections and store both short-term and long-term memories. So the initial observation of the decrease in cyclic AMP was made by Dr. Elizabeth Berry Kravis, who's now a professor of pediatric neurology at Rush University Medical Center in Chicago. And what Dr. Berry Kravis showed was that cyclic AMP was decreased in the tissues that she sampled. And she showed that prior to the identification and cloning of the FMR1 gene. So this is a bedside to bench translational program, because after the gene was cloned and the Drosophila, the fruit fly and mouse models of Fragile X were developed, it was found that there was a decrease in cyclic AMP in both of those animal models. So we've developed a compound, BPN-14770, that targets a phosphodiesterase known as PDE4D, which increases cyclic AMP in the brain. We know that PDE4D is an important component of learning and memory in humans, because ultra-rare missense mutations in that gene cause profound intellectual disability. The disorder is known as acrodysostosis type 1. So having that in hand, we were following the literature, and there's been considerable work on whether or not modulation of cyclic AMP and Drosophila and mice might improve the Fragile X disorder in these models. So we collaborated with the FRAXA Foundation. They performed preclinical testing in the FMR1 knockout mice. And what we found is that our compound improved behavioral phenotypes. It facilitated maturation of cortical circuitry. And when you washed the drug out and retested the mice two weeks later, the behavioral improvement was maintained. So that provided us impetus to go into a phase two clinical trial with our compound. And lo and behold, the compound or the clinical trial reported positive findings. So we used for the first time a set of cognitive tools that were developed as part of the NIH toolbox. So these are cognitive tests that can be performed by people with profound intellectual disability. So we were directly assessing cognitive performance over the course of the clinical trial in adult men with Fragile X. We also incorporated caregiver measures, a visual analog scale that assessed three different domains of patient function, as well as a physician-reported cognitive scale or outcomes. And what we found is that using the NIH toolbox, we saw improvement in verbal in tests assessing verbal knowledge. Patients and caregivers in their reports assessed three domains, two of which were language and daily function, and both of those were also found to improve. We did not correct for multiplicity of testing. This was an exploratory trial, and we had a large number of different assessments that we conducted. Nonetheless, we're very encouraged. We have a drug which in mice affects cortical circuitry. We expected a change in cognitive function, and that's exactly what we're seeing. We also saw trends, and we also saw persistence of effect. So this was a crossover trial. In the first arm, people on drug did better than placebo. In the second arm, the people that started on drug and crossed over to placebo showed continued improvement or maintenance of improvement. There are also trends for improvement in biomarkers. We saw a trend for improvement in the amplitude of the auditory evoked response potential. And we also saw improvement in a biomarker that's altered in people with autism. So we're really encouraged. We used a novel clinical assessment tool, the NIH toolbox. This is something that has not been presented to FDA prior to our trial. So we're working with FDA now to help them understand the clinical significance.
This excerpt came from the Fragile X Syndrome in Pursuit of a Cure webinar that took place on World Fragile X Day 2021. It was hosted by Wuxi AppTech in partnership with FRAXA Research Foundation. Follow the link above or in the description below to view it in its entirety.